Hi everyone, I'm Ben, and this is the Board Game Blueprint. This week, we'll be taking a closer look at some of the accessories for the mint tin, which was covered on a previous episode of the show. So let's jump on over to the table next door and see what we have in store. So while perusing the Game Crafter, I stumbled upon this little mint tin game called Glyph Dice Adventures by Candace Duffy Jones. And what caught me first of all was the fantasy art. Unicorns, we could definitely use more of those in games, I think. But also the components inside or included in the game. So let's just kind of jump on into it. Before we do that though, this is a great example of the actual printing on the mint tin directly, as opposed to a mint sticker. And what's pretty cool is that they found the right balance to get the tin to not exactly shine purely through, but as you can see that there is a matte finish on both the clothes of this character here and the sort of fur of the unicorn. So the way that that's accomplished is using off-white as white, pure white, FFF on the hex code will show through as the tin itself. Trying to capture that. I think maybe you can see it right there. But anyhow, let's kind of jump on into it. On the back side as well, you can see, yeah, like this die line is the reflective tin itself, but then the dice themselves, as printed, are not kind of transparent, so to speak. But yeah, let's go ahead and open up. This is what you can expect inside. You normally shrink wrapped. I removed that for this video, but it's a little bit of packing paper, and we can remove that because there are these mint tin cards. So again, these are a little bit smaller than business cards, which is cool. And obviously that's to help them fit perfectly inside the mint tin without their corners getting a little flushed out or bent around the edges, so to speak, to fit inside. But these ones specifically are also punch outs, which is really nice. And these are kind of hidden units or currencies, excuse me, for the game itself. From what I recall, it's a bit of a storytelling game, and we'll get to the main part of that as well as soon as I just punch out these right there. Perfect. So you have like these really mini cards, which are pretty fun, I think, for keeping in front of your hand and such, being a little bit secretive and all that good stuff. But let me just go ahead and pop these right back in here. As you can imagine, or probably you could recycle the frames once you're done with them, because you really only need these bits here. But the other appeal to Glyph Dice is, well, the dice themselves. So thought we'd also show off a custom component. These are the custom printed dice, and we'll get them up close and personal in the video here. Yeah, let me just put that off to the side. So these colors look really, really nice. And as we can see, yeah, like the ink is pretty much printed right on there. So you might have a hard time, well, I won't say a hard time scratching them off. I don't necessarily want to try, but I do recall when these custom printed dice were first released, TGC announced that they ran through a dry cycle of a tumbler or of a dryer and were a-okay. So I totally trust that fact. Now, I think there was on one of them, I saw a little bit of a, like a color smear, so to speak. And basically, all you have to do is just kind of like wipe it off, which is really nice here. So let me just get that piece of lint off my hand and see if I can find one such piece, one such die face. But yeah, it looks like they all came out really nice. So we could see that there's like a slight little smudge there. I mean, it's not even that noticeable, but we'll just wipe it right off. And then we're pretty much good to go. But yeah, so these dice, I believe you roll them and you have to kind of form a story with the revealed or upturned icons, at which point you will then reward the storyteller a certain number of gems you feel is appropriate. I hope I got those rules right. That was just a quick, brief overview. Mainly, I wanted to show off, again, the mint tin itself as a carrier vessel and, well, what's inside. So real quick, too, the dice should fit inside here and then close up. Whoops. And let's see. Almost there, I think, as well, if we removed these extra frames, right? Because these would not be wholly in here, and we kind of like split them up into different sides of the mint tin. Oh, and then have the dice maybe on the other one, such and such a way. Yeah, we can already see that now it will close with the extra kind of thicknesses of these cards after being punched out, fitting inside. So that's pretty nice. And again, a nice tight package. If you had the packing paper still, I'm looking around for it. And oh, there it is. You could maybe use it to cushion up the rest of the dice so that they aren't totally rattling around while carrying. But Let me get this on camera. Whoa, that was really loud. Sorry, everyone. Yeah, I think it's a really fun package. And so the other fun part about these mint tins is that we also have what's referred to as mint tin accordions. Dun, da, 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 in three different sizes. And basically, they're fold-out cards, which is really cool. I've seen, or I really want to, use these as rules for a game, and I love just how compact they are. Right, like you can just fold it right out, give it to somebody to read off while you're setting up the rest or something like that. These are just really cool, and they also could work as screens, as seen in a previous video or some such. So again, this is four cards, basically, yep, eight different sides, so to speak, to use. Let me see what these other ones are. This one is the next largest, which is six cards. Yep. And then we also finally have eight cards all the way across, and it's just so fun. It's kind of like a wallet, if you will, and you can kind of unleash or release and let things fall down. I think that could be a really fun aspect of a game, and maybe that's what it is pretending that these mint tins are wallets so that we can actually show off all of our beautiful photos. If you have, and that could be something cool as well, is using these as a marketing opportunity for a game, and each one of these faces is a different design of yours, perhaps. Wow, that's it right there. They're kind of like children, so why not? Why not? And yeah, that's just a quick preview at the mint tin, as opposed to just what would fit inside, but seeing a fully realized mint tin, as well as then mint tin cards, which fit directly again into the mint tin itself, and custom dice along with the mint tin accordion. So there we have it. I hope that is pretty cool for everyone, and I hope that, yeah, you really have a few different ideas rolling around in that head of yours now. As I said before, I hope this video gave you a couple maybe new ideas for how mint tins can maybe suit your own designs, either present or in the future. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and click that bell icon so that you can stay notified when the next video goes up. As always, I'm Ben. This has been another episode of the Board Game Blueprint, and together, let's build something great.